there's a bit of a stalemate with not much communication coming from government. What have you heard as far as the projected way ahead?
Well, I haven't heard anything. I'll tell you what, I assessing the whole situation. What we have in this country right now is a vacuum of leadership. Mm-hmm. You know, King Mswati, in the last year, since we had COVID, has only appeared in public 3 times. That's not good for Swaziland, because people, you know, there's this thing that the king must always be there. We need to know that he's there to feel secure. So he's sort of gone into a self-isolation. He's appeared at the Inkwala. He appeared when he opened parliament this year, and he appeared once last year, just after the lockdowns of COVID, just to sort of give us strength on it. Otherwise, he's been an absentee king. Not good. And then we had a prime minister die in December, the substantive prime minister. So that opened another leadership gap. And unfortunately, the guy who was his deputy, who's now running government, is completely incompetent. He doesn't know what he's doing. So that is why this space has opened up for those agitating for change to take it up, because our leaders have abandoned us. They're just not there.
Mr. Bheki, Makhubu, we'll leave it at that for this afternoon, but thank you for a very comprehensive breakdown of exactly what's happening in Eswatini. He says the looting, the burning of tires, and the shutting down of Mbabane and Manzini is still very much in place, waiting for leadership and a direction and a way forward there. He is editor of The Nation magazine.